God had done so many good things for the Israelites. He had rescued the Israelites from slavery in Egypt and had taken care of them in a new land. He made a covenant with them and promised to be their God. Even though God loved them like a father, the Israelites forgot about God. They acted in the same way as the nations who did not know and love God.
They worshiped things that were not God, and they did exactly what God told them not to do. So God sent prophets to warn the people to stop doing evil things. Did Israel listen? No. The prophets said bad things would happen if they did not obey God. Did Israel obey? No. In fact, they sinned even more.
Finally, God had enough. He loved his people too much to let them continue in their sin and rebellion. So God punished the people of Israel by letting their enemies take over. Hoshea was the last king of Israel, the northern king. King Hoshea did evil things like the kings before him.
But Hoshea had to do whatever the king of Assyria told him to do. Instead of asking God to help his people, Hoshea secretly asked the king of Egypt to protect Israel from Assyria. Now that Hoshea had a deal with Egypt, he stopped giving money to the king of Assyria.
One day, the king of Assyria and his army attacked Israel. King Hoshea was thrown into prison. The Assyrian army surrounded the city of Samaria, the capital of Israel. Samaria had a strong wall around the city. For 3 years, the Assyrians attacked the city. They did not let anyone bring supplies into the city. Finally, the king of Assyria captured Samaria and forced the people to leave their homes. He bound them together with ropes and hooks, and he made them walk hundreds of miles to Assyria. The northern kingdom of Israel was destroyed.
When the Israelites disobeyed God again and again, God punished them by removing them from his presence. We disobey God, but Jesus took the punishment for our sin upon himself. Jesus brings us into God's presence and keeps us there.